Hello, Heart of the Lion Ministries. This is Evangelist Christian back with you again with another burning prophetic message for you and the body of Christ. I am going to get straight into this right now, though I will wait a few seconds. But like I always say, even though the majority of people, hey, Brother Matt, God bless you. Anyhow, even though the majority of the people will join by recording, this is a now prophetic word for the body of Christ. And I have three main scriptures for you that I'm going to share. But the main one that God wants me to share with you is Mark chapter 4, verses 35 through 41. I'm going to read the scripture and give you the prophetic message that is tied along with the Word of God. It says on the same day, well, actually, I'm going to start with 33. And with many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear it. But without a parable, he did not speak to them. And when they were alone, he explained all things to his disciples. So that is not confusing. I know some of our different translations can kind of mix things up. What that meant is he didn't speak to the biggest crowds really without a parable. But those smaller crowds that he knew that were really more interested in spiritual things and really under, you know, knowing what he had to say, then he spoke with them plainly. But let's just get in straight to the rest of the scripture. On the same day when the evening had come, he said to them, let us cross over to the other side. Now when they had left the multitude, they took him along in the boat as he was, and the other little boats were also with him. And a great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat so that it was already filling. But he, meaning Jesus, Yahushua, he was in the stern, asleep on a pillow. And they awoke him and said to him, Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? Then he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, Peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. But he said to them, Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly and said to one another, Who can this actually be that even the wind in the sea obey him? Okay, there is a lot here, and I can get into a lot of, you know, teaching, but I want to stick to what really the message that God wanted me to share with you is based off of this. Just like Jesus, who was not fearful and got up from the stern and looked at the enemy in the face, in the eye, and declared the exact opposite from what he was experiencing, that's where we have come in the body of Christ. Regardless of where we see we're going, regardless of we see what's happening, through blessings, through judgments, God has prepared many of us and many of you for the things that you've gone through that you thought were maybe a waste of time. They have actually created something in you and has activated something in you that you do not realize, and you might realize, but many do not realize that is there. And that is power, and that is greatness, where God has been burning up the flesh so that Christ could be formed in you. However, the word is, once again, we have come to that place like Jesus Christ, like Yahushua, got up, straight pit bull tenacity into the face of the wind, the sea that was filling the boat. And he rebuked it. He told it, you shall not go any further. There is so much here that I can teach, but there's some two other ones I want to speak to you about. But this is the now word for the body of Christ. It is not time to shrink back. God cares about what you're going through. He cares about your emotional situation. He cares about it all. But this is not a time to shrink back. Right now, as we're moving forward as the army of God, it is not time to get discouraged. It is not time to shrink back. It is time right now to look at the eyes and the face of the wicked and the enemy, regardless of what that front looks like. Nationally, we see what that front looks like. We've got this pandemic. We've got some shaky economies. We've got some people getting sick. Regardless of what that front looks like financially, health-wise, relationally, it is now time for you to get up and to look at that situation and to tell it to go where it needs to go, and that is back to the pit of hell. And Jesus Christ, Yahushua HaMashiach, was able to do this because he was not only God in the flesh, but because he was surrendered to the Holy Spirit. He was surrendered to what God was doing. Yes, he was full of the Spirit. Yes, he was God in the flesh. But you know what? He still experienced the temptations as we did. He received, he knew and could experience the draw of the temptation. He knew what that was like. And so we are called to do the same thing. And this is why he even, look how he talks to them. If I was to say this to some people, you would think I'm rude. And they might have thought he was rude at the time. But look what he says to them, even though they are perishing and dying for the most part. Or they might die in their perception. But he says in verse 39, then he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, peace be still. So not only did he stand up to the tormentor, whatever the enemy is tormenting you with, you're going to have to stand up to it, just like Jesus, just like Yahushua did. You're going to need to tell it to change. Now is the time to tell it to change, regardless if it's your health, your finances, regardless of what it is. But look at what he says to them. But he said to them in verse 40, why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? Now, let's put yourself in that situation. You're in the boat. It's not sunny. It's not exciting. It's filling up and you're ready to die. And God rebukes you for being fearful. You know why? Because Jesus, Yahushua, he was not just teaching a principle of, I'm God and you shouldn't fear just like me. It's a part of that. But you see, he's teaching actually a spiritual understanding and revelation. Fear is the breeding ground where you aid the enemy to execute what he's trying to do and manifest in your life. This is why he rebuked them so hard. He said, if you let fear in, you're going to aid the enemy to torment and harass you. This is a time to put out all fear. This is a time to reject fear and to reject what you see the report is. Because that's why the Bible says, whose report are you going to believe? Just like the scouts of Israel, those who brought out a bad report, they received rejection from God. And they were not able to walk into the promises that God had for them or the promised land. It's about reports right now. Jesus, though he was physically eye to eye with the report of the ocean and the wave, he told it to go back to hell where it came from, because that storm arose because Satan was trying to block them to not only get to the other side, but to finish ministry and salvation, because there was a lot of breakthrough and miracles that were going to go on once they got to the other side. My word, the word that God has for you, it is time to look at the face of the enemy and to call those things that aren't as if they are. And that's the other verse we're going to go through. But I'm going to get to the second one that God spoke to me, because a lot of people are still saying, but well, you know what? I'm not Jesus Christ. I'm not God. And you know what? You're right. But you're a daughter and a son of righteousness. You're a daughter of Eve and you're a son of Adam. And Jesus Christ is that second Adam. He came to repair and give us the dominion and the authority that we lost in the Garden of Eden that he won back for us at the cross of Calvary. You are called to do those same things. And I'm even going to prove it in the word. And here's the second word that I wanted to share that God spoke to me to share with this word. John 14:12. It says, most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these he will do, because I go to my Father. And whatever you ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. And we can see the end there is an exhortation about prayer. But the beginning there, it says, we're going to do the same things as Christ, and even greater. Some people rationalize that greater, meaning only greater because the Holy Spirit has been given in the earth, and that means in scope. No, it means both. And not only both, you're going to do at least the same and greater. Not only in scope, but in power as well. But it is time to look at those things that you're dealing with and to not accept the report. Do not get depressed. You need to walk in the expectations of the Lord, which brings me to the last scripture. You must expect it to turn around. Yahushua expected it to turn around. Yes, he had the glory and power of God. Yes, he was perfected. But once again, he knew what it was like to be tempted. He knew what it was like to be in flesh. He knew what it was like, and he still rebuked them. So you got to rebuke that fear out of your life and the voices of the tormentor. See, Satan specializes in fear. Satan specializes in torment. That's why Jesus rebuked them. You got to get the fear out. You can't entertain it. This is why Satan is on a terrorizing campaign within the media. He knows how the spirit realm works. If he could get you to entertain these fear of all these things and pandemics and being financially destitute and all of these things, he's going to have an open door. Yahushua gave him not even a little. It was zero. Nothing. He gave him nada. And now is the time to raise up to that same standard. Don't be discouraged. Rise up and tell that thing to change in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. And here's the last scripture. Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good testimony. What does that mean? Faith is the currency. It's the substance that precedes your provision and miracle. But more than that, I will break it down very simply. It's expectation. Remember the prophet Elijah and his servant. He prayed for rain, and it did not happen for 6 times. He kept sending his servant, and he didn't give up because he wasn't just hoping. He was playing a lottery machine, throwing dice that God might just say, okay, this time. He knew his God. He knew that's not who it was. He knew he just needed to keep going and not give up. And some of your people are at that place. You've tried. You've tried. You're on the 3rd try. You're on the 4th try. You're on the 10th try. You're on the 100th try. But I'm telling you, God is going to unlock something in you that you didn't even know that was there. But you got to stand up. You got to stiffen the spine. You got to get strong. And you got to tell the fear to leave. You got to have the Lord strengthen you. Yes, ask for his power, but rebuke it in his name, because you have that ability. You have that ability to rebuke it and to bind it. Just like the prophet Elijah did not give up, you have to expect. That faith you're going to need is tied to expectation. That is your currency, that God's looking at your heart and your mind to see if it's there. Even when you're not giving up, even when you keep hammering, even when you keep hammering, even when you keep hammering, and little lo and behold, all those hammer strikes, you're going to build something for the kingdom of heaven you didn't even know that you were doing. Don't give up. God has you. Don't be discouraged. He has everything in control that you're going through, but he knows exactly how to get the world out of you as well. And it's creating a greater glory and anointing and presence upon your life, especially during this time of Hanukkah, as the oil, it represents a lot of things, but the Holy Spirit in the oil that ran 8 days, I decree that oil is going to run through your life and a new anointing, a new power, but you got to stand up. You have to stand up and you cannot flinch. It is time, yes, it is time for strength. It is time for grit. And it's time for pit bull dog tenacity to look at those situations that you're going through that the devil is trying to torment and terrorize you with. It is time to stand up, to tell the devil and his assignments where to go and speak the opposite. Life. Blessing, prosperity, healing, signs, wonders, because we're not of the economy of this world. The problem, if you look to the economies of this world, if you look to the solutions of this world, you're tied into this world. But our solutions do not come from this earthly plane. It comes from the kingdom of heaven, who creates just by the thought and word of his heart and his mind. It is time to get strong and it is time to believe. And I speak and I decree that what has been on the inside of you, ready to be unlocked, that greater works, that power, that answer, whatever those answers are, whether they're financial, relational, healing, whatever it may be, I decree that they're going to come to pass in your life. But the word to the body of Christ now is you have to stand up. You have to stay strong, and it's time to look at the enemy straight in the eyes and to bind him up and to tell him where to go. You shall not have my life. You shall not have my destiny. You shall not have my kids. You shall not have my future spouse, my current marriage, whatever it is you're struggling with. It is time to draw the line in the sand and to expect what you're expecting in prayer and to expect to receive it, what you're asking. Just like the prophet Elijah didn't give up. And even after the fourth, fifth, and sixth time, by that seventh time, he saw it. And the reason why he didn't give up is because he knew his God. He knew that it was around the corner. Because not all answers come right away. Some do, and some don't. But I hope that is an encouragement to you. To you, Brother Matt, a faithful brother there. Much blessings and love out to you as well in the Dominican Republic. And to everyone else who is listening and watching this, I just wanted to release this before I continued on in my day as I'm in the beautiful Northwest here in the state of Washington, actually right on the coast. But blessings to you. Yahuwah bless you and keep you, and may his faith shine upon you. Be strong, and I decree that greater works anointing to do the same things as Yahushua and beyond is being unlocked in inside of you and upon you and through you right now in Yahushua's mighty name. Be blessed until next time.